So thank you very much, Speaker, sir. And I thank every member of the House who has spoken and taken interest in the budget which has been presented here. Let me at the outset thank the people of this country for giving this government, headed by Sri Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji, a historic third consecutive term in office. It actually reaffirms the faith the people have and the commitment with which Honorable Prime Minister is leading the country, and therefore building stability and coming up with people-centric policies, we shall all work together to build a Viksit Bharat by the year 2047. I am extremely humbled by the trust faced. I am extremely humbled by the trust vested in me by Honorable Prime Minister, and it encourages me to work even harder to attain government's vision of Viksit Bharat. I would like to thank all the members for having participated in this robust debate, and I am trying here to address almost all the issues raised by the honorable members, and I shall go by issue, which would cover many members under each issue, but I'll try to name as many of them as possible. So I'll, just before I do the part where I'm responding to the honorable members, I would like to highlight some of the budgetary points, features, which is very important for us to understand where this budget fits in itself in the long path towards Viksit Bharat. Sir, this budget actually draws upon what was mentioned in the vote on account. So essentially infuses into itself everything, almost everything said in the vote on account. And after that, of course, brings a newer addition towards making this year the first step towards the next 5 years leading towards Viksit Bharat. So the continuity from the vote on account is something that I'd like to underline. The principle of governance has from 2014 been Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Vishwas and Sabka Prayas. And following that, we shall come forward and work together to make sure we overcome all the difficulties. The budget actually seeks to consolidate all the earlier accomplishments. It also outlines measures in order that we overcome the challenges, and two core elements have been highlighted. One is the social inclusivity, that is reaching out to all strata of the people in the society, and geographical inclusivity through equitable development for all the regions in our country. So we are taking a whole of nation approach and now seeking to make sure that we fulfill the aspirations of our people. So briefly, if I were to summarize on points which are meeting this objective that we have set before ourselves, is the expenditure of the government has actually grown exponentially. It is today 48.21 lakh crores. It is projected to grow by about 7.3% over 23-24 and 8.5% over pre-actuals of 23-24. We call it pre-actuals, although with the final figures are almost there, because it has to be certified and audited, we give the nomenclature pre-actuals. But they are close, actually close to the real REs. Within the total expenditure, sir, one feature which has marked India's growth story post the COVID, it is the capital expenditure which the public money with which we are building assets, meaning government's own expenditure to build assets, to build capital expenses, are the ones. Capital expenditure is the one which has actually enabled us to come out of COVID, whilst many other countries in the world are doing very many different things. But yet, this one tested formula of depending on the multiplier which comes out of spending on public expenditure, spending on capital expenditure through public money, has actually yielded us such results that post-COVID, consistently we've maintained high growth rate and we are the fastest growing in the world as a result of this very clear government's approach. And in that total expenditure of 48.21 lakh, 11.11 lakh go for capital expenditure. Sir, budgeted capital expenditure is now almost 3.3 times the capital expenditure which was there in 2019-20, that is prior to COVID, sir. If you actually calculate the effective capital expenditure, that is the sum which is referred to when the budgeted capital outlay and the grants and aid for creation of capital assets which is given to the states, grants and aid go to the state's capital account, but it remains in the revenue account for us. But because it also creates capital in the state's name, if we were to calculate the effective capital expenditure, it is pegged at 15.02 lakh or above 18% over the RE of 23-24. So that is the impetus we are giving for growth to be sustainable and for us to retain the growth rate that we have been very clearly attributing for the hard work of the people of this country. I'm not getting into the details of the revenue expenditure because that is already in the budget documents. But more importantly, I get into talking about the allocations because I think a lot of members have said probably the allocations in the social sector has come down. I want to, by giving the data, I want to showcase to the ministers, to the honourable members, that the expenditure on the contrary has gone up in each one of them, and I'll show by how many. So agriculture and allied sector in 2013 and 14 had just 30 lakh crores, meaning 0.30 lakh crores, whereas now it is 1.52 lakh crores. It is even 8,000 crores more than the last year, which is 23-24. So even over last year, we have made an increase and not brought a reduction in them. So education and employment and skilling is the next one, sir, in which 0.85 lakh crore is what was allotted for education, employment and skilling in 2013-14. Whereas today, it is 1.48 lakh crores, which is 23% more allocation even over the last year, 28,000 crores more than last year, which is 23% more allocation compared to even last year. In 10 years, 0.85 lakh crore to 1.48 lakh crores, sir. Women and girls, 0.96 lakh crore in 13-14, it is 3.27 lakh crores. 41% more allocation or 96,000 crores more than the last year. Rural development, including infrastructure, sir, 0.87 lakh crore. And this year, that is 2013 and 14, whereas this year it is 2.66 lakh crores, which is 11.7% more allocation over the last year, 28,000 crores more than the last year. Urban development was only 0.12 lakh crores in 2013-14, whereas it is close to a lakh crore now, 7,000 crores more than last year. Health and social welfare, sir, 0.72 lakh crores in 2013-14, it is now 1.46 lakh crores, 3,000 crores more than the last year itself. So nowhere has the budget given lesser allocation than the previous year. So I would want to appeal to many honorable members to please have a look at the document in full and see that no allocation has been reduced. Sir, just briefly, what the budget 2024-25 tries to bring in is a balance among several objectives, because growth is important. And through better growth, higher growth, we believe that inequality can be addressed. So growth, employment, welfare spending, capital investments and fiscal consolidation. These are the factors which we've tried balancing in the budget. So an indicator which is very important for us, if I'm insisting on doing public spending on capital expenditure, the quality of public spending is the revenue deficit to fiscal deficit ratio normally. From about 80% in 2020-2021 COVID year, on account of COVID pandemic, the revenue deficit to fiscal deficit ratio, sir, was expected to fall to 36% for was very high, whereas it has now fallen to, it is expected to fall to 36% in 24-25, and therefore reflecting the fact that expenditure is going towards quality asset creation. No one can refute this data, sir. These are all available in public domain. And the other thing which is an important indicator is, I had promised in this House, sir, 21-22, that the government would endeavour to attain fiscal deficit to GDP level below 4.5% by the year 25-26, from an unprecedented high of 9.2% in 2020-2021. We have kept completely to the trajectory projected. We have not deviated from it. We are complying by that fiscal deficit trajectory given by me. Even today, you see that we've gotten close to the 4.6. Actually, this year, we have clearly given 4.9 as the fiscal deficit. So we are keeping our word on that. India's exceptional post-pandemic economic recovery to become the fastest growing economy over the last 3 years is truly magnificent. And I thank every citizen, the middle class, the entrepreneurs, the farmers, marginal workers, traders, everyone who I've mentioned, I've not mentioned, deserve big gratitude, a word of thanks from all of us, sir, because they, because of their toil and hard work and belief that they have to bring up the situation for their families to be better, has resulted in India becoming the fastest growing economy. And how many nations, may I ask this year, how many nations have achieved this balance through the budget since post-COVID to retain that growth, ensure that this balance happens and continues that sustainable growth momentum? So at least these sort of things which have to be remembered for the sake of thanking our people, I would like to highlight these as the last few years' achievement of this government and entirely thanking the people of India. And this couldn't have been possible unless there is a hard-working, visionary leadership which takes us forward so that the country can really come out of the COVID distress. And I thank Honorable Prime Minister for his leadership on this. Sir, I had also presented the Jammu Kashmir budget for 24-25. I'm happy to inform that the concrete steps that have been taken to enable the Union Territory to break free from the fetters of the past, namely the legacy of fiscal distress which has been inherited from the erstwhile state. We have provided substantial financial support, and I'll give the number, 17,000 crores in the Union budget of the UT of J&K this year. It includes 12,000 crore towards financing the cost of Jammu Kashmir police. That's a burden we want to take on our shoulders so that J&K has more flexibility to spend money for developmental activities. And the additional central assistance of 5,000 crore has been provided. With this support, I expect the GSDP ratio, fiscal deficit to GSDP ratio of the Union Territory would be somewhere, and I'm estimating it, somewhere in the range of 3% for the year 24-25. The public finances of the Union Territory are now back on the rails, and they are now able to focus on developmental activities much more than ever before. And the fiscal prudence is the biggest spirit with which the welfare activities are being taken up without any compromise on Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. So Because Jammu and Kashmir budget was particularly of interest to some of the members, I would like to respond to the members as well, much before I go to responding to members on the general budget. Sir, some members of J&K have raised questions about unemployment rate in J&K. Mia Altaf, MP, and also Honourable Member Aga Syed Ruhullah Mehdi. They have raised issues about unemployment, and I would want to put it on the record of this House. Unemployment rate, that is for the age group of 15 to 59 years, has actually come down for J&K from 6.4% in 2020-2021 to 5.7% in 21-22 to 4.4% in 22-23, sir. So there is a reduction in the unemployment rate in J&K. The reduction is primarily because there is a lot of avenues being created for self-employment, and livelihood opportunities through Government of India schemes are reaching all people in J&K, and as a result, you can see that employment opportunities in the sense of self-employment has actually grown. Sir, again, Honourable Member Mia Altaf had raised this issue about the works that were undertaken by the Union Territory Government for the welfare of tribals. I'll certainly like to say, sir, there are about 9 important things which need to be highlighted. The Union Territory Government has undertaken several initiatives for tribal welfare in the areas of healthcare, education, culture, infrastructure development, and livelihood. After 2 decades, actually, forest rights were granted to tribal communities. Do shatak ke baad, intizar ke baad, tribal communities ka unka hak forest rights ke dwara diya gaya hai. 5,943 forest right certificates have been issued to the tribal people. First ever survey of the nomadic tribal population has also been conducted. Transport facilities are being provided to the nomadic tribes and the Bakarwals because they move up the range during summer and come down from the higher reaches to the lower levels. Transport facility is also being provided. Transit accommodation is provided to migratory tribal communities. Again, the communities which move from colder to slightly warmer regions in winter, including community kitchens, medical and veterinary dispensaries, and community toilets. All these have been provided for the migratory tribal communities. Professional coaching centers, scholarships, skilling for 48,000 tribal youth, 8 new hostel buildings, 285 smart schools, 6 Ekalavya residential schools have all been developed in the Union Territory of Kashmir. 80 schools to be transformed into smart schools in the tribal areas. That's a very important step forward, and it will benefit tribal children. 186 tribal villages are being developed under the PM Adi Adarsh Yojana, so helping tribal communities. Tribal Research Institute is being developed in Srinagar, and these are some of the very specific measures being taken by the government, and I hope the Honourable MP has got substantial information on the question that he asked. Sir, now I come to the general budget, in which I go by issues in which many members of parliament have spoken, so I've clubbed together members. The first issue I take up is members from the opening speaker, Kumari Shailja, Professor Saugata Roy, Hebe Eden, Dr. T. Sumati, Charanjit Singh Channiji, and many others have all spoken about how there is a threat to cooperative federalism. Only few states have been given the benefits in the budget. Sir, I'm very sure, I would like to humbly state this, I'm sure all the members know that in a budget speech, if a state is not named, it doesn't mean that no money goes to them. And therefore, that was a misleading campaign, which, being in the opposition, unfortunately, a lot of members did speak about. It pains me to know. It pains me to know that they could say that if you're not mentioned in the budget speech, your state gets nothing at all. Sir, I would like to... I'd like to tell you, Honourable Speaker, sir, from 2004-05, sir, 2004-05 onwards, first of all, I'll say Baki Rajyon ko kya hai wagera, but I'll first say some things. Sir.
कोई भी मान्य सदस्य बैठे बैठे कोई भी टिप्पणी करे तो आपको उसका जवाब नहीं देना.
ठीक है सर.
बिना परमिशन
सर. सर सर आई विल टेक द एग्जांपल सर. Sir, I'm picking up on the budget speeches since 2004-05, 5-6, 6-7, 2007-08, and so on, sir. 2004-05 budget did not take the name of 17 states. I like to ask the UPA government members at that time, did money not go to those 17 states? Did they stop it? Then if they stopped it, they have every business to ask this question. I presume they didn't stop money going to those 17 states because they didn't name it. So when it is one thing for them, it's all right. When the same thing happens somewhere else, no, it's not all right, you've deceived. 17 states were not named in 2004-05. 18 states were not named in 2005-06. 13 states were not named in 2006-07. 16 states were not named in 2007-08. Money didn't go to them. 2008-09, 13 states were not named. 2009-10, 26 states were not named. 26, which means only two. Sir, oh yes. Sir, if we are being blamed that only two states were named and the other states are not getting anything, 2009-10 budget had only two states, Bihar and Uttar Pradesh, and no other state. What does that mean then? It's all right when you do it. You didn't give money to those states which you didn't name. So, sir, you can't have it both the ways. You do one thing and then you blame the same thing on somebody else. What happens to the states which were not named? I'm asking now, 2009-10, 26 states of India did not have a mention. 2009-10, the full budget, 20 states. Interim budget did not have 26. The full regular budget, 20 states did not have it. So what does that mean, sir? They continue to ignore states. 2010-11, 19 states were ignored. 2011-12, 15 states were ignored, they didn't mention. 12-13, 16 states were ignored. 13-14, 10 states were ignored. So, sir, for that matter, the interim budget of 2014-15 ignored 26 states. Oh. Was there a noise? Did people say you ignored those states, you didn't give money? So, if you want to distort and create uproar, you want to give a sense of fear among people, you can go about distorting data. But this stands here, sir. Sir, in the last few years, now, each state, we had ministers go and explain how much has been given to each of the states. All right, sir.
रिकॉर्ड तो है, रिकॉर्ड है दादा, इसीलिए रिकॉर्ड होता है, वकीलों के पास.
सर, आई जस्ट वांट टू से दिस सर, जस्ट रैंडम एग्जांपल्स ऑफ हाउ मच हैज गॉन टू डिफरेंट स्टेट्स. bulk drug parks in Himachal Pradesh for now 1,900 crores. Very recently announced by Prime Minister Modi. PM Mitra Textile Park went to Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Telangana. Have they not received monies for that? 500 crores for Greenfield Park and 200 crore for Brownfield Park. These are just random examples, sir. Railways, West Bengal, Jharkhand and Bihar, multi-tracking of Son Nagar and Andal. Telangana and Maharashtra. Yes, yes, it is everybody's right and that's why I'm answering. But instead of reading a complete list, I'm giving random examples so that people can understand. Railways, Telangana and Maharashtra. Doubling of Madked, Medchal, Mehboob Nagar, Don route. Telangana and AP. Doubling of Motumarri, Vishnupuram sections. Telangana and AP, Bhadrachalam, Dronakkal sections. Amount, sir, 12,334 crore. West Bengal, Jharkhand, Bihar. Telangana and Maharashtra, 4,686 crore. Telangana and AP, 1,596 crore. Telangana and AP, Bhadrachalam, Dronakkal section, 770 crore. These are going for railways alone.
Himachal Pradesh 27.
Sir, major highway projects, Kerala. Major highways projects. Sir, I would like to put on record because after all, the respective honorable members of Kerala insisted and I'm glad to receive them that much before I deliver the reply today, I have to meet with them. It was an all-party delegation. I happily met with them. I have no problems. I will address issues also that we have stated and let it go on record that all the MPs came and met me before I gave the reply. I have no hesitation, sir. And there is no vanchana to any state. Nobody is being denied any money. So, India's first, sir, Kerala I mentioned, NH66. Kappirikkadu, Edappalli in Thrissur district. 9,667 crore major highway project, Kerala. Sir, major money comes, na? 9,606 ongoing. Money comes or not? So, Mukkola Junction to Kerala, Tamil Nadu border, 1,148 crore. Sir, J&K. Punjab, Haryana, Delhi, Delhi, Amritsar, Katra road project, 18,000. Sir, kindly, honorable speaker, sir, J&K, Punjab, Haryana, Delhi, Delhi, Amritsar, Katra road project, 18,274 crore. Sir, again Kerala, sir, India's first transshipment port. All of us happily celebrated when a very big vessel reached Virinjam port. Kerala government, Congress government gave it. And nobody from who are speaking about AA's and A1 and A2's don't question Kerala Congress government when Virinjam was given on invitation to, I'm not taking the name, one of the A's. On invitation. And nobody went. Nobody from Congress party went and said, why are you giving to AA? Can't give it to AA. They didn't say. And afterwards, when communists came, when communist party came to power in Kerala, even they did not disturb it. Congress gave it, communists came afterwards, even they also didn't touch it. How much of viability gap funding has been given from by Government of India, sir? 818 crores have been given for Virinjam port by Government of India. For a project that they themselves invited someone of the A and gave it, and that one of the A was given by Congress. Another who came as a communist also did not touch it. It's going on fine till today. But lectures on AA is only for all of us. Sir? conservative federalism, states not being mentioned in the budget speech doesn't have to be a very big issue. They all know they have presented budget in this country for decades. But when it is a ordinary chai wala OBC leader who comes to become prime minister and he does administration well, you then have a problem. Are kya ho rahi hai? Is he doing well? No, we'll have to protest. This will not work out, sir. People are seeing this game. So total resources allocated to transfer of states in BE 24-25 is 22,91,182 crores, and that is an increase of 4,93,645 crore, 27.5% over the last year's BE. States transfer to states 22,91,182 crores. Sir, you know the size of the budget. And rightly, that much which is due to go to the states are going on time. Then, of course, sir, I've spoken about the criticism about not mentioned in the budget speech. I don't want to elaborate. There are other things. Agricultural allocation has come down. And legal guarantee for MSP. This also has been spoken by more than 20 speakers. Honorable 20 members have spoken. I'll just elaborate. I know Honorable Minister Shivrajji has been answering a lot of questions related to agriculture in the last few days. There may be some repetition in my statement, but I'd like to highlight. So the budget allocation for the Department of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare was only 21,934 crores in 2013-14. 13-14 mein 21,934 crore rupees hi tha agriculture ke liye allotment. Magar abhi 24-25 mein wo badh karke 1,23,00,000 ko 1.23 lakh crore ho gaya hai. 5 guna increase hai, sir. Sir, more than 3.2 lakh crores have been disbursed to over 11 crore farmers under the PM Kisan since its launch. 3.24 lakh crores has been disbursed for 11 crore farmers. Sir, institutional credit targets for agriculture has increased more than 2.5 times. 2014-15, it was 8 lakh crores. Now it is 20 lakh crores. Kisan ko ye paisa institutional credit mil raha hai. Interest subsidy is also being given to Kisan. It has increased 2.4 times. 2014-15 mein 6,000 crore interest subsidy ke saath kisanon ko loan milta tha bank se. Abhi wo badh karke 14,252 crores hai sir, is sir, 23-24. Number of accounts of small and marginal farmers availing agricultural loans has grown from 57% to 76%. 14 mein 57% loan agricultural farmers lete the. Abhi 76% loan le rahe hain subsidy ke saath, isliye ye number aur badhegi kyunki hamare prayatn kisan ke saath acha chal rahi hai sir. Sir, also a committee has been constituted some time ago to look at how the CACP cost, agricultural commission for agricultural cost and prices can work better so that kisan ke liye jo bhi suvidha milna chahiye उसको बेहतरी तरीके से मिलाने के लिए कैसे काम करना उसके ऊपर ये कमेटी काम कर रही है. सर, आई वॉन्ट टू हाईलाइट, इफ एनीथिंग आई थिंक मेनी ऑफ अस स्पीकर्स हैव ऑलरेडी सेड दिस, बट आई लाइक टू हाईलाइट दिस पॉइंट सर. टुडे सर, द कांग्रेस पार्टी एंड द इंडिया अलायंस पार्टनर्स आर ऑल डूइंग गुड लॉट ऑफ पॉलिटिक्स on the farmers. I'm saying it with consideration, sir. I'm not speaking loosely. The National Commission on Farmers, MS Swaminathan, had recommended in 2006 minimum support price should be at 50% more than the weighted average cost of production. This was not accepted by the UPA government. The cabinet note, which was drafted in July 2007, said, and I quote, sir, MSP is recommended by the CACP on objective criteria considering the variety of factors involved. Therefore, setting an increase of at least 50% on the cost may cause distortion in the market. In some cases, there may be a mechanical linkage between MSP and cost of production per producer. इतना कहकर के एम एस स्वामीनाथन के रिपोर्ट को दरकिनारे कर दिया यूपीए गवर्नमेंट ने 2007 में। फिर 2004 मैनिफेस्टो में कांग्रेस पार्टी बोलते हैं कि एक कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव क्रॉप इंश्योरेंस ले आएंगे, मगर सचमुच में पीएम फसल बीमा योजना ले आने वाले कौन है सर? हमारा प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी। फिर कांग्रेस पार्टी ने यह भी कहा, इट वुड एग्जामिन द फीसिबिलिटी ऑफ डायरेक्ट इनकम सपोर्ट टू फार्मर्स, मगर किसान सम्मान निधि 2019 में ले आने वाले कौन है सर? माननीय प्रधानमंत्री मोदी जी। इसीलिए कांग्रेस पार्टी दे कैन गो ऑन शेडिंग क्रोकोडाइल टीयर्स अबाउट फार्मर्स, कोई इम्प्लीमेंटेशन में कुछ नहीं किया पिछले 10 साल में, ऊपर से आई वुड से इवन फॉर सेवरल डिकेड्स कुछ भी नहीं किया। द फेलियर ऑफ द फ्लैगशिप लोन वेवर, सर मैं फेलियर ऑफ द लोन वेवर 2008 के ऊपर बात करना चाहता हूँ। 2008 के चुनाव में किसान के लिए लोन वेवर के ऊपर इतनी सारे बातें किए, CAG फाउंड ग्रॉस इररेगुलरिटीज इन द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द 50,000 करोड़ एग्रीकल्चरल डेट वेवर एंड डेट रिलीफ स्कीम्स। एक आध विषय उसमें CAG रिपोर्ट में कहा गया कि अराउंड 164 करोड़ वॉज वेव्ड ऑफ इन वायोलेशन ऑफ द गाइडलाइंस। इंप्लीमेंटेशन में पूरे के पूरे गपलाबाजी करने वाले कांग्रेस है सर। 22% ऑफ द केसेस में लैप्सेस एंड एरर्स पाया गया। 8.5 फार्मर्स आउट ऑफ द अकाउंट्स ऑडिटेड वेर नॉट एलिजिबल टू गेट लोन्स। शायद जीजा बच्चीदा आ गए इसीलिए लोन जिनका मर्जी दे गए, कोई इसमें मेशरिंग मापदंड कोई फॉलो नहीं किया। 34% ऑफ द एलिजिबल बेनिफिशियरीज ऑफ द टेस्ट चेक अकाउंट्स वेर नॉट इश्यूड डेट वेवर सर्टिफिकेट। ये मैं मानती हूँ बेरहम एक स्टेप है सर, जिसमें अगर बैंक वो सर्टिफिकेट नहीं देता वो किसान दोबारा लोन नहीं ले पाता। 34% ऑफ द एलिजिबल केसेस में वो सर्टिफिकेट तक नहीं दिया गया, इनके लोन वेवर जिसके ऊपर वो जीत कर आए 2009 में, उतना गपलेबाजी हुआ उसमें, आज किसान के ऊपर रो रहे। सर अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट के ऊपर 15 ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स ने बात किया सर, इसमें कुमारी सैलजा, अभिषेक बैनर्जी, सौगता रॉय जी, हिबी ईडन, राजीव राय, दुराई वाइको, पप्पू यादव जी, डिंपल यादव जी, एनके प्रेमचंद्रन जी और के सुब्रायन जी, ऐसे बहुत सारे, डॉक्टर सुमति अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट के ऊपर बात की। मैं उनका एक आध विषय स्पष्ट करना चाहती हूँ सर। सर आ पॉलिसी टू मेक यूथ, इस बजट में यूथ के लिए 5 ऐसे स्कीम का एक बड़ा सा पीएम का युवा पैकेज हमने ले आए, जिसमें एम्प्लॉयमेंट भी है, स्किल ट्रेनिंग भी है, इंटर्नशिप भी है। आ पॉलिसी इज देयरफॉर टू मेक यूथ सक्षम, स्वतंत्र और समर्थ, इसीलिए टू मेक देम कॉम्पिटेंट, इंडिपेंडेंट एंड केपेबल। A lot of schemes have been brought in other than the 5 schemes put into PM package. 48 crore mudra loans worth 29 lakh crores have been disbursed since 2014. 29 lakh crores ka dispersal hua mudra mein. Isiliye is bar kyunki wo success hua hai, hum usko 20 lakh rupees tak अमाउंट बढ़ा रहे हैं, 10 से लेकर के 20 तक बढ़ा रहे हैं। मैं ये पांच स्कीम के ऊपर ज्यादा बोल नहीं रही हूं सर, बट आई वॉन्ट टू से यूपीए इरा में जॉबलेस ग्रोथ के विषय में एक विषय हाईलाइट करना चाहती हूं सर। आरबीआई के क्लिम्स डेटा जो पीरियोडिकली हमें इकोनॉमी के ऊपर पिक्चर देता है, वो एम्प्लॉयमेंट यूपीए के इरा में मतलब 2012 टू 13 में और 13 टू 14 में टोटल एम्प्लॉयमेंट एक्चुअली डिक्लाइन हुआ है, ये वो जिक्र करता है आरबीआई के रिपोर्ट। उनके कार्यकाल में जब टोटल एम्प्लॉयमेंट का नंबर डिक्लाइन होता है उसके बारे में चर्चा नहीं करते। मैं आज उठा रही हूँ इस हाउस में कि उस समय के एम्प्लॉयमेंट क्यों घटा, व्हाई डिड इट कम डाउन? इफ यू आर क्लेमिंग दैट योर इकोनॉमी मैनेजमेंट वॉज ऑल वेरी गुड, हाउ डिड टोटल एम्प्लॉयमेंट फिगर कम डाउन? एंड दिस इज आरबीआई डेटा, नॉट माइन। सेकेंड सर, फॉर्मल एम्प्लॉयमेंट वॉज बैडली हिट, टोटल पर्सन्स एंगेज ड्यूरिंग द यूपीए टाइम, एनुअल सर्वे ऑफ इंडस्ट्रीज कहता है कि कोविड पैंडमिक के टाइम, हमारे सरकार के टाइम से ज्यादा डिक्लाइन उस समय हुआ टोटल पर्सन्स का एंगेजमेंट में। दिस इज अ डेटा अबाउट 2012-13, एम्प्लॉयमेंट टोटली टोटल पर्सन्स एंगेज डिक्लाइन हुआ उस समय। सर, वी वॉन्ट टू हाईलाइट द फैक्ट दैट एनुअल पीरियोडिक लेबर फोर्स सर्वे reports show that the labor market indicators for persons in the age group of 15 years and above has steadily improved under Prime Minister Modi. 2017-18 to 2022-23, our employment figures have improved. I'm giving you at least four indicators for that. Labor force participation has increased from 49.8 in 2017-18 to 57.9% in 22-23. Labor force participation number. Isme women labor force participation has risen to 37% in 22-23 from 23% which was in 2017-18. Women ka participation bhi increase hua. The unemployment rate has declined from 6% in 2017-18 to a low of 3.2% in 22-23. Youth unemployment for the age group 15 to 29 has declined sharply from 17.8% in 2017-18 to 10% in 22-23. So, the last point on this employment debate, sir, SBI research report, which was released in July 2024, said India created 12.5 crore jobs between 2014 and 23, compared to only 2.9 crore during the UPA das saal. 2.9 crore UPA ke das saal mein, magar abhi 12.5 crore hamari das saal mein, sir. So employment ke upar baar baar galat fehmiyan prachar karna ye chhod de, kyunki data uske khilaf hai. Next is the question of inflation management. In inflation, periodic labor force does not include NAREGA, sir. Does not include. I'm sorry. No comfort on that. Sir. Sir, inflation. Sir, inflation, sir. Inflation as a subject. Seven honorable members spoke about it. I'm not taking their names. Sir, we saw double-digit high inflation period during the UPA era, and that is because of their reckless policies. I want to differentiate between the inflation which prevailed during UPA and the inflation, if at all, within the range which prevails now, some months which have gone up. There is a difference. डोमेस्टिक इन्फ्लेशन यूज टू बी हायर देन द ग्लोबल एवरेज ड्यूरिंग यूपीएस टाइम. ग्लोबल फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस 2008 सर. इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट कोविड विच इज मच मच मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स देन द ग्लोबल फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस. ग्लोबल फाइनेंशियल क्राइसिस 2008 यूपीए गवर्नमेंट took stimulus measures to boost the economy. But I'm sorry to say, I'll come to this particular matter because it has a relevance to one of the honorable members. Harvard and Oxford educated leaders, UPA government was run by them for the economy, did not know when and how to withdraw the stimulus, leading to a high double-digit inflation between 2009 and 13, high fiscal deficit and debt crowding out private investment. So between January 2012 and 2014, just the 22 months, of the total 28 months, 22 months the inflation was above 9%, almost double digit and almost double of the forbearance limit that is permitted. इन्फ्लेशन के इनके रिकॉर्ड ही है सर. उसको बीट करना आसान नहीं है. इसीलिए मैं बात बोल रही हूं, यूपीए सर, यूपीए इनहेरिटेड अ स्टेबल मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक एनवायरनमेंट विद इन्फ्लेशन एट 3.8% from 1999-2000 to 2003-04, Atal ji ke samay par inflation us range mein par tha, usko inherit kiya UPA ne. Comparatively, annual inflation rose to 8.1% between 2004-05 to 2013-14. अटल जी का 3.8%, इनका 8.1%. यही है इनका रिकॉर्ड इन्फ्लेशन मैनेजमेंट के ऊपर. सर एक्चुअली क्योंकि हमारे एमपी साहब ऑलरेडी एक स्लोगन दे रहे, मैं बोलना चाहती हूँ, मैं हिंदी इलाके से नहीं आती हूँ फिर भी ये याद है, कांग्रेस आई महंगाई लाई, ये है इनका रिकॉर्ड सर. Because economy was in such poorly managed state because of inflation, I want to quote sir, RBI governor, unka naam nahi le rahi hu kyunki sadas nahi hai idhar, magar wo ek kitab likhe hain, us kitab mein wo bolte hain, I quote, the finance ministry used to pressurize the RBI to soften interest rates and present a rosier picture of growth to shore up sentiments. क्योंकि आपके आर्थिक व्यवस्था इतना बिगड़ गई थी, आप RBI को फोन करके उनको बोल रहे हैं कि प्लीज ठीक से मैनेज करो भैया, क्योंकि सेंटिमेंट अफेक्ट हो जाएगा. आप कुछ मैनेजमेंट नहीं किए, मगर ये किताब में फॉर्मर RBI गवर्नर लिख रहे हैं सर इनका इकोनॉमी के मैनेजमेंट के ऊपर. शेम, वो हमें पूछते हैं कि इकोनॉमी कैसे मैनेज कर रहे हो सर. इंडियाज इन्फ्लेशन बिटवीन 2020-2023 इज मच लोअर देन द ग्लोबल एवरेज. प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी इन स्पाइट ऑफ कोविड planned the economy in such a way that our inflation did not affect so badly. I want to just give you the list of the records, sir. NDA ke samay 99 to 2004 tak 3.8, UPA 1 mein 6%, UPA 2 mein 10.2%, so UPA 1 and 2 put together 8.1%. Abhi hum aa rahe hain NDA 1 mein, 14-15 se lekar inflation 5 years mein 4.5%, NDA 2 mein 5.7%, NDA 1 and 2 put together 5.1%. Kahan hai 8.1%? Hamare 5.1% kahan hai? Ye main ye bhi dukh ke sath kehna cha rahi hu, jab Pradhan Mantri ji पेट्रोल और डीजल प्राइस को दो बार कम किए, बीजेपी स्टेट्स ने कम किया, इन्फ्लेशन हटवाए, मगर यूपीए के स्टेट्स कोई भी कुछ नहीं किया, उसके वजह से उनके स्टेट में इन्फ्लेशन हाई रहा। देश के लिए नुकसानदायक पॉलिसी है यूपीए का। ठीक है, हम कैसे मैनेज किए इन्फ्लेशन? ग्रुप ऑफ सर, एनडीए गवर्नमेंट कैसे मैनेज कर रही है? ग्रुप ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स के द्वारा इन्फ्लेशन को मॉनिटर करते हुए सप्लाई साइड का हर स्टेप हर बार उठाते हैं। मैं उदाहरण देती हूं सर, भारत ब्रांड आटा, राइस और पल्सेस का विषय हमने खरीद करके सब्सिडी के साथ जनता को पहुंचा रहे हैं। भारत आटा एट 27.50 रुपीस पर केजी, और लोग खरीद रहे हैं कि नहीं खरीद रहे हैं? बिल्कुल खरीद रहे हैं। 14.87 लाख टन हैव बीन सोल्ड फॉर कॉमन पब्लिक। भारत राइस 27.5 रुपीस पर केजी में चावल मिलता है और 13.98 लाख टन बिक्री हो गए हैं सर, लोग खरीद रहे हैं। भारत चना दाल 60 रुपीस पर केजी के, 1 केजी का पैक 11.52 लाख टन सोल्ड हो गए। भारत मूंग दाल, बोथ मूंग दाल और साबत मूंग दाल 2,984.37 टन का सेल हो गया है। आम नागरिक तक हमारे भारत ब्रांड आटा पहुंच रही है, इसीलिए इन्फ्लेशन को वो फेस कर पा रहे हैं। सर, मैं अगले एक विषय मुख्य विषय में आ रही हूँ। SC ST को इग्नोर कर रहे हैं सरकार, विमेन एंड पुअर को इग्नोर कर रहे हैं। इसमें चार लोग बात किए, चरणजीत सिंह सनी, श्रीमती डिंपल यादव, के राधाकृष्णन एंड तोल तिरुमावलवन, ऑल मेंबर्स, ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट हु हैव रेज्ड दिस इश्यू। आई वांट टू से SC और ST और विमेन के एलोकेशन हैज गॉन अप सब्सटैंशियल। नंबर दे रही हूँ सर, 23-24 में 1,59,148 crores था SC का, इस साल 1,65,493 crores, 6,345 crores और बढ़ाए। ST 1,19,706 crores, 1,24,909 crores, now 5,113 crores अधिक, वी हैव इंक्रीज्ड इट। विमेन 2,38,220 crore पिछले साल, इस साल 3,27,158 crores, 88,938 crores ज़्यादा दिए हैं इस साल में। सर, इस विषय में थोड़ा ऑनरेबल स्पीकर ध्यान से आपके सामने विषय रख रही हूँ। SC ST का एलोकेशन कम हो गया है, ऐसे प्रश्न पूछने वाले से मैं पूछना चाहती हूँ। कर्नाटका के कांग्रेस गवर्नमेंट ने SC ST फंड से बजट में 9,980 दिए हुए बजट से 4,301 करोड़ ट्राइबल सब प्लान से निकाला गया, उसका पता नहीं चल रहा कहां है। सो फार ऑफ द टोटल कर्नाटका गवर्नमेंट हैज स्पेंट 2,228 करोड़, इंक्लूडिंग 1,587 करोड़ फ्रॉम द SC ST सब प्लान एंड 641 करोड़ फ्रॉम द ट्राइबल सब प्लान स्पेसिफिकली। गॉड नोज वेयर दिस इज गोइंग, बिकॉज दिस हैज बीन क्वेश्चन इन कर्नाटका इटसेल्फ बाय द लीडर ऑफ द ऑपोजिशन एंड द मीडिया। आई वॉन्ट टू आस्क माननीय फॉर्मर चीफ मिनिस्टर चरणजीत छन्नी जी, आपके लीडर से बात करिए, कर्नाटका में जाकर के SC का हालात के ऊपर प्रश्न पूछिए। इधर पूछने का आवश्यकता नहीं है, उधर कांग्रेस गवर्नमेंट में हो रही है इतनी सारी गपला। फिर कर्नाटका से एक और विषय सर, जरूर मैं मानती हूं कांग्रेस में SC के विषय में बात करने वाले हर नेता कर्नाटक आज ही जाए पूछने की क्या हो रही है। एससी के पैसा को निकाल करके प्राइवेट अकाउंट में डाला जा रहा है, किसी को मालूम नहीं हो रहे। एससी के ऊपर इधर लेक्चर हो रही है, महर्षि वाल्मीकि शेड्यूल ट्राइब्स डेवलपमेंट कॉर्पोरेशन स्कैम, बड़ा सा स्कैम सर। इसमें सर विषय देख लीजिए कितना इंटरेस्टिंग बात। नॉर्मली गवर्नमेंट स्टैंड्स अप टू से नो गपला, क्या आरोप लगा रही हो, सॉरी, ऐसे बात करने के लिए सरकार के पक्ष में से खड़े होते हैं। मगर उधर नाम नहीं ले रहा हूं, मुख्यमंत्री जी खड़े होकर के बोल रहे हैं, अरे भैया वो 187 करोड़ नहीं है, सिर्फ 89 करोड़ है, जो गपला है, मगर नॉट 187 करोड़ बट ओनली 89 करोड़। ये देख लीजिए क्या कॉन्फिडेंस,
यही कांग्रेस है।
गपला करो फिर आर्ग्यू करो, बोलो कि 189 नहीं है भैया, जस्ट 89 है, छोड़ दो जी। एससी का पैसा सर, एसटी का पैसा सर, दोनों उधर गपले हो रही है, मगर इधर एससी के ऊपर लेक्चर हमें दे रहे। एससी के ऊपर चीफ मिनिस्टर पंजाब के प्रश्न पूछ रहे, कमल।
इन द पास्ट बीजेपी गवर्नमेंट
स्किल इंडिया मिशन के ऊपर ऑनरेबल मेंबर अभिषेक बैनर्जी, ऑनरेबल मेंबर ओवाईसी जी और वरुण चौधरी जी ने प्रश्न पूछा। आई वॉन्ट टू हाईलाइट तीन ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स, अभिषेक बैनर्जी जी, ओवाईसी जी और वरुण चौधरी जी ने प्रश्न पूछा। इन द लास्ट डिकेड, क्योंकि डिजिटल पब्लिक इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इतना नेसेसरी हो गया है, स्किल इंडिया डिजिटल हब में कैसे क्या है विषय, उनका कंसर्न है स्किल इंडिया मिशन में सक्सेस नहीं हुआ। मैं उनको जेंटली बोल सकती हूँ, इन द लास्ट डिकेड द एम्प्लॉयमेंट ऑफ इंडियन यूथ हैज़ इंक्रीज्ड शार्पली, राइजिंग फ्रॉम 34% इन 2014 टू 51% इन 24। ये सब क्योंकि उनका स्किलिंग हुआ, उनके अपग्रेडिंग ऑफ स्किलिंग हुआ, उसके वजह से वो आगे आना संभव बन रहे। और इस बार बजट के द्वारा 5 स्कीम्स का पैकेज, पीएम स्किल फॉर यूथ और एम्प्लॉयमेंट फॉर यूथ के पैकेज के द्वारा इसको और आगे बढ़ाएंगे, यूथ के लिए हम काम करेंगे। और हमारे पोजिशन सर वर्ल्ड स्किल्स कॉम्पिटिशन में 19th पोजीशन में थे हम 2017 में स्किलिंग में, आज 11वीं पोजीशन में 11th रैंक में आ गए हैं बाय 2020। सर थ्री मेंबर्स हैव स्पोकन ऑन पॉवर्टी एंड ग्लोबल हंगर इंडेक्स, पॉवर्टी एंड ग्लोबल हंगर इंडेक्स, कुमारी शैलजा जी, दुराई वाइको जी और गुरमीत सिंह जी। Sir, I want to first of all, with all humility and modesty, say flawed indicators such as the Global Hunger Index, for India's sake, may not work out. I'm not saying because you have raised a point, but I'll tell you why. In sabke vishwasniyata, I'll try to say it in Hindi, sir. मैं इस ग्लोबल हंगर इंडेक्स की विश्वसनीयता पे कुछ बात रखना चाहती हूँ। हाँ मैं प्रश्न रखना चाहती हूँ, हाँ हाँ मैं जो विषय मैं क्वेश्चन के द्वारा जवाब दे रही हूँ। कॉन्फ्लिक्ट ट्रिगर्ड कंट्रीज सर, पाकिस्तान जैसे कंट्रीज को, सूडान जैसे कंट्रीज को भारत से आगे रैंकिंग कैसे मिल रहा है सर? अफ्रीकन नेशंस में आज भी उनका पर कैपिटा इनकम भी कम है, फिर पाकिस्तान में आज तक आटा के क्यू, मैं आई एम नॉट सेइंग इट इन अ सेंस ऑफ यू लुक एट देम दे आर सफरिंग, नो आई डोंट वांट देम टू सफर, बट इट इज अ रियलिटी। टुडे दे आर नॉट एबल टू ऑब्टेन इवन बेसिक फूड. हियर 80 करोड़ लोग के लिए भारत देश में मुफ्त में हम अनाज दे रहे हैं, फिर भी हंगर इंडेक्स में हाई है. ये कैसे ये विश्वसनीयता स्थापित करेंगे सर? हाउसहोल्ड सेविंग्स बिल्डू बिल्डू हाउसहोल्ड सेविंग्स एट 50-year लो व्हाइल हाउसहोल्ड डेट हैज बीन इंक्रीज्ड. श्री ऑनरेबल एमपी अभिषेक बैनर्जी ने ये प्रश्न पूछा. सर ईयर वाइज अक्यूमुलेशन, दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग डेटा सर, आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑनरेबल मेंबर्स टू काइंडली पे अटेंशन टू दिस फैक्ट. नेट फाइनेंशियल सेविंग्स ऑफ द हाउस होल्ड सेक्टर फ्रॉम 8.32 lakh crores in 2013-14 has risen to 14.616 lakh crores in 22-23. Net financial savings of the household sector. This is an increase of 70%. Household savings in the form of physical assets. Bank mein fixed deposit mein cash rakhna ek cheez hai, magar ghar khareedna ya ghar mein vistar karne ke liye kamra banana, wo alag vishay hai. Today in the form of physical assets, sir, construction of houses or other immovable properties increased from 14 lakh crores in 2013-14 to 35 lakh crores in 22-23. It clearly indicates a shift of savings in the form of physical assets rather than in the form of financial assets. The registered investor base at the National Stock Exchange has tripled from March 2020 to 2024 to 9.2 crores of Indians 31 March 2024 tak. So potentially translating into 20% of India's households now are channeling their household savings into financial markets. Ye hum dhyan mein rakhna chahiye sir. I'll come to that. I'll certainly come to it. Sir, Honorable Speaker, sir, I'm almost coming to the end, sir, but one or two important points. Sir, I thought you wanted the answers. Sir, lack of transparency in budget. Lack of transparency in budget was the issue raised by Honorable Member N.K. Premchandran. I want to highlight the fact, sir. In fact, it is completely the opposite of what used to prevail under UPA. And I'll give you examples with which I want to say this charge, lack of transparency in budget, should actually be posed by N.K. Premchandran ji to UPA budgets. Sir, all the details have already been provided. I'm not going to say what is revenue reserve, how much is revenue receipt, how much is other receipts. The borrowings are meant for financing fiscal deficit, because the question also said how government will finance the additional allocation of around 56,000 crores. So I want to just highlight, borrowings are for financing fiscal deficit in a way. I would like to mention that the borrowing has been reduced due to better fiscal management and reducing the fiscal deficit from 5.1% in interim budget to 4.9% in the regular budget of 24-25 explains that. The hallmark of Prime Minister Modi from the days when he was Chief Minister of Gujarat is fiscal prudence without compromising on welfare. He continues on that trick. He has not compromised on welfare businesses or schemes, but very clearly manages his finances carefully, and that is why you have that fiscal prudence reflecting in the fiscal deficit. Sir, this is a total contrast to what had prevailed during UPA. I want to highlight how the Congress-led UPA government, constant practice of hiding the deficits through off-budget borrowings and issuance of oil bonds, which shifted the fiscal burden to future generations. Under the UPA, standard fiscal practices were routinely changed to make the budget numbers look favorable. You saw, I've already said how the RBI governor spoke. In order to make an impression of nice, goody goody, you call the RBI, you fudge the numbers, you put it under the carpet. All this has happened during UPA, not our time, sir. In financial year 2021, the government, our government under Prime Minister Modi, rapidly repaid all outstanding national small saving fund loans which were provided to the FCI in lieu of food subsidy by providing additional budgetary support. We cleared the accounts, sir.
Very good.
And as a result, that came on to the budget, and there was no hiding under the carpet, external borrowing kar diya, budget mein dikhaya nahi, main budget fiscal deficit acha number dikhaunga, magar idhar borrow karte rahe. Nahi. Everything that you get, everything that happens in finance ministry is now in the budget for all of us to see. इसमें कोई पीछे से बोरो करो उधर रखो इधर दिखाना नहीं है नहीं होता सो लैक ऑफ ट्रांसपेरेंसी अगर है तो वो यूपीए के गवर्नमेंट में हुआ था अभी नहीं कंप्लीट फूड सब्सिडी अंडर द पीएम के पीएम गरीब कल्याण अन्न योजना इज बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड ट्रांसपेरेंटली थ्रू गवर्नमेंट बजट सर फ्रॉम 21-22 ऑफ बजट फंडेड स्कीम्स आर बीइंग प्रोएक्टिवली डिस्क्लोज्ड इन द बजट डॉक्यूमेंट इसीलिए हर स्टेप हम ले रहे हैं ट्रांसपेरेंसी की ओर आई वॉन्ट दिस टू बी रिकग्नाइज बाई द ऑनरेबल मेंबर सो द लास्ट टू मेंबर्स हु आस्क्ड पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन सर ऑन द माइनॉरिटी बजट हैज बीन रिड्यूस्ड ऑनरेबल मेंबर जियाउर रहमान बर्क फ्रॉम यूपी आई फॉरगेट हिज कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी संबल But I must say, sir, you normally don't allow us to mention names of people who are not the members. But with your permission, I want for a moment to pay a momentary dedication to his grandfather, Shafiqur Rahman Bark, late Sri Shafiqur Rahman Bark, because he was a very elderly member. He came several times to meet me on his constituency-related problems. I used to respect him. I gave him a lot of time to understand his issues. And where I could help, I have helped him. But not for that, but I do recognize the dignity with which he has approached his assignments, even with that aged, even with that seniority in age. So I want to respect the grandson who's now come in his position, who's asked this question. Sir, minority budget, has it come down? No, it hasn't come down. I want to very clearly say, sir, 22-23, actuals are 803 crores. 23-24, budget estimates were 3,098 crore. 24-25, budgetary estimates. 3,183 crore, 85 crores more than the last year has been given. No reduction in the fund. Sir, under NMDFC, which is National Minorities Development and Finance Corporation, since 2014, 8,300 crores worth of loans have been disbursed to more than 22.5 lakh minority beneficiaries, of whom 85% are women. So the young new member, I want to give him the thing, information. And the last one, sir, under insurance problem in the country, and there is a 18% GST on health insurance. This was asked by Honorable Member Karthi Chidambaram. I want to highlight that PM Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana has over 20 crore enrollments and over 16,087 crore claims have been paid till date. 2 lakh insurance cover at just 436 rupees per annum premium. We have paid 2 lakh, we have paid 20 crore enrollments. And 16,087 crores have been cleared as insurance claims. PM Suraksha Bima Yojana, sir, 44 crore enrollments and 2,757 crore claims have already been paid. And what is the structure, sir? 2 lakh rupees for total disability or accidental death at just 20 rupees per annum premium. So this is the way insurance for the common people have been given by Prime Minister Modi, and this is reaching a lot of poor people. And I'm happy to say, even during COVID, we had cleared a lot of claims, even if they didn't meet the usual requirements of doctor's certificate, mortuary certificate, nothing. PM gave a clear instruction saying, during COVID, all claims be settled. We don't want anyone to suffer because insurance certificates are not done. Sir, sir, this is not something I very much would want to speak about, but there are one or two things which I need to highlight before I come to the last 2 points, sir. Professor Saugata Roy has raised a lot of issues, but I'm astonished, sir, from the land of Bengal, which inspired our freedom movement, which gave us the slogan, Vande Mataram. Here, yeah, you don't hear me all right, no? Vande Mataram. I'll be happy to say it 10 times. Vande Mataram. Bengal gave this call. And we are very inspired by that. And from that Bengal today, we have a Professor Saugata Roy, who says, I'm not bothered, I'm not worried, but it is worth mentioning for this House's consideration. He says, I do not expect Finance Minister to be like Dr. Manmohan Singh. Certainly, I also don't want to be like Dr. Manmohan Singh. She is not a PhD from Oxford, not even like Chidambaram, who has got a management degree from Harvard. She's from our own JNU. But the problem is she's bereft of new ideas. Seedha mein aa rahi hun, sir, prashna. Seedha mein aa rahi hun, prashna mein. A lady who I respect a lot. A lady who I respect a lot. Who sits equally in the GST council with me. Srimati Chandrima Bhattacharji. Who is the finance minister of Bengal. Studied in University of Calcutta. Sir, you may delete the name, sir. You may delete it, sir. Finance Minister of Bengal, studied in University of Kolkata. That's all right, sir. I respect her. Which means, is she also bereft of new ideas? Is she also bereft of new ideas, sir? I don't want to take her name. Finance Minister of Bengal. Please delete the name. I am not against it. I respect her, sir. She does wonderful contribution in the GST Council. She is from University of Kolkata. So, when reference is made to me saying she's from JNU, but the problem is she doesn't have any. She's bereft of new ideas. Is she bereft of new ideas? Equally, I want to ask, the Chief Minister of Bengal is also from colleges affiliated to the University of Calcutta. Does it mean that if you study in Indian universities, you are bereft of ideas? She is a fighter who's leading the state for so many years. Make shameless comments. Sir? I'll come. Sir, I'm astonished. When we talk about the Chief Minister's qualification, and saying that she's a good chief minister who's fighting. We are from Indian universities. Whether it is Chief Minister of Bengal or myself, we are all from Indian universities. In what way we are less to the Harvards of the world, the Oxfords of the world. I want to ask this question to the male chauvinist professor who seemed to be attacking women, and even worse, he is a professor in one of the Indian colleges. He is not teaching in Harvard. He is not teaching in Oxford. So is he also equally not so qualified? A professor in Indian university demeans people who have got qualification from Indian university, sir. Professor Saugata Roy, please be ashamed of yourself. worse. Even worse. He says, in 1920, the inequality, sir, the inequality in India was less in 1920 than it is now, is a statement professor made. I can't believe this statement. Sir, Bengal suffered under the British. We all see the images of skinny, starved bone and skin Indians, Bengal people who were starved by the British, and the entire grain of West Bengal was taken to fund the war. People were photographed sitting skinny with bones and skin, and that Bengal was better in equality than now? What a shameful statement to make. In this house, inequality was better under British than now? What a shameful statement to make. Now I come to talking about Bengal's economy, sir. I'll give all the white paper they want. Sir, West Bengal's share in total industrial production of this country. Honorable Speaker, sir, I like to draw your attention and say West Bengal's share of the total industrial production of this country, which used to be 24%. I want honorable members to keep paying attention to this data. It's very important for this country. 24% was Bengal's contribution to total industrial production of this country at the time of independence. Today, you want to know what that number is? 3.5. That's the Bengal economy. That's the Bengal economy. Sir. Sir, there's been a downward trend in the gross capital formation. In 2010, West Bengal accounted for 6.7% capital formation in India. Now it accounts only for 2.9%. They want a white paper? I'll give a white paper. I will definitely give a white paper. This is the performance of Bengal's economy, sir.
सभा की कार्रवाई आज 8 बजे तक बढ़ाई जाती है।
The state of West Bengal, sir, attracts less than 1% of the total Indian FDI.
अगर आप सवाल पूछोगे तो जवाब दे सुनना पड़ेगा। आपने सवाल किया तो जवाब दे रही हैं वित्त मंत्री जी।
Supriya Sule had asked question about fiscal deficit target of 4.9% may not be achieved. With supplementary demand, it might go up to 5.6%, is her apprehension. I want to reply to Honorable Member Supriya Sule, sir. The year-end actuals of a year represents the full financial year's expenditure. It is inclusive of additional appropriation that may have been granted to the Parliament by the Parliament through supplementary demand. But I want to lay before Honourable Member my fiscal deficit numbers. 21-22, the fiscal target set was 6.8%. What we achieved is 6.7%. 22-23, 6.4 was the target set. 6.4 was achieved. 22-23-24, 5.9 was target set. 5.6 was achieved. And 2024-25, 4.9 is what we mentioned here. I'm confident that of achieving that fiscal goal and the glide path which we have given. And therefore, 4.5% of GDP for 25-26 is what we will achieve, is my hope. Sir, before I come to the conclusion, there's one I will come to the conclusion with. But before I come to that, sir, I want to highlight the fact.
Mane Sadashya, Neta Pratipaksh, please. Sam. आसन के पीठ पेट कर नहीं बैठते
संविधान नेता प्रतिपक्ष हो जाने से अकल कहां से आएगा
सर दिस इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट इश्यू आई वांट टू रेज सर बिफोर आई कम टू द कंक्लूजन सर टुडे व्हेन वी आर डिस्कसिंग द जर्नी ऑफ विकसित भारत आई वांट टू ड्रॉ योर अटेंशन टुवर्ड्स अ वेरी सीरियस इश्यू To make India develop, it is necessary for the country to have big economic and strategic power. But if there will be instability and anarchy in the country, the journey towards Vikasit Bharat will become more difficult. This is a huge challenge for us.
Bad job.
And as a nation, we have to understand where the problem is. India's social fabric. Parliamentary traditions, economy, and the armed forces are all four being severely attacked. We have united our diverse society through the hard-working people of this country over the generations. After independence, sir,
our
constitution was put in place, and it has put in place several arrangements to keep the society united. But today, through a conspiracy, the fault lines of our society are being exposed. Mistrust is being created against each other in the society through fallacies, lies, and deceit. Sir, efforts are being made to create such a situation that even a spark will lead to a lot of conflict. Similarly, the attacks on the armed forces are also being intensified. On some pretext or the other, or one pretext or the other, efforts are being made to divide the army and the soldiers. The strength of the army is its discipline and unity. As a part of a conspiracy, sir, this strength of the army is being challenged. Whatever is happening today regarding Agniveer is a part of this conspiracy. I'm afraid to say this. Apart from the society, parliament, army are all under attack. And even the economy is being attacked. When the people of India have really struggled to come out of COVID and are building a society on their effort. We as people representing them in this house at least should recognize the hard work of our people and not undermine India as a country which is growing at this rate. So entrepreneurship itself is being made a villain, sir, which is a shame. Hard-working entrepreneurs are building this country. The conspiracy is to end India's entrepreneurship culture even if before it fully blooms and thereby hitting at the Indian core backbone, which is the entrepreneurship, small and medium units, and enterprise is what is building India. Negativity is being spread in society towards all those who do business. And this hatred for business and wealth creators is spilling everywhere. There is a conspiracy to send a message to the entire world that India is not safe for investors, sir. And this is not good. Rumors are being spread that Indian institutions cannot guarantee security to foreign investments, which is really a sad situation, sir. Strategic instability, economic instability, and political instability. Some forces are working to create this kind of an image of India, and we should all fight together that this kind of instability building people should be told a lesson. There is a huge nexus behind this, which is carrying out this conspiracy from the streets and even to the parliament. No debates without protests, which are aggressive protests, are happening. You don't even hear answers which are being given. And I'm sorry to remind this honorable house that when the Honorable Prime Minister stood up to speak, utmost disruption happened and people did not want to listen to him. They were screaming. But parliamentary institutional maryada ke upar unse first lecture aata hai. Jab all over the world they had people standing and people were forced or nudged or cajoled to say, go into the well, protest. Sir, institutional respect, we have to keep it. Every countryman has come together to fight this conspiracy. We have to be alert, sir. And I take this opportunity to say this. Sir, the last matter, sir. Sir, the last matter. The last matter, sir. Halwa. Okay? We should talk about it. Sir, it pains me, sir. It pains me, actually. If only we know the background with which halwa ceremonies are conducted before the budget is prepared. If only we know the background. Sir? If only we know the background of why halwa ceremonies happen, sir. It's a very important phase where actually in this country halwa ceremonies have been happening for a very long time.
Manyamantri, kab se ho rahi hai, bhi bata do aap.
Main bol rahe hai, sir. Minto Road mein, jab printing press tha, jab budget udhar print hota tha, tab se lekar ke, staff who get themselves inside that premises, budget प्रेजेंट होने के बाद तक जब बाहर नहीं आते थे, आज भी वो सिस्टम बरकरार है. वो लोग अपने आप, क्योंकि अंदर जाने के बाद टिल दे कांट कम आउट टिल द बजट इज रेड, ऑन दे ओन यूज टू ऑर्गेनाइज हलवा मेकिंग. क्योंकि भारत में एक ट्रेडिशन है, कोई भी अच्छा काम शुरू करने से पहले नींबू मीठा. That time, sir, sir, now Ratri, meaning 9 nights and 8 days, Purane Zamane mein, they used to stay inside only, no phone, no contact, no landline. If anything, one officer who was given the power to come in and go out, he would convey the message. Kuch nahi aur bahar world se sampark.
Abhi kya hua?
Bol rahi. Please. Abhi sir, 5 nights and 4 days nowadays they stay in the cellar of North Block. And this is essentially because the confidentiality of budget making has to be respected. So they go in, and before going in, we start this halwa ceremony. And there are media reports, sir, one or two which I'll read out, which captures it. Halwa ceremony, sir, one media report says, and I quote, "It serves as a recognition for the hard work and dedication of the finance ministry officials and staff who have been diligently preparing the budget documents. Dating back to 1980, the halwa ceremony precedes the printing of the budget documents, which take place at the basement of the North Block, a process that must be completed without any official leaving the premises until the budget formally is presented." So this is done more, unquote. Now I again take one line. "A sense of solidarity and teamwork among the team members ke liye ye bana karte hain. It also says it stands as a testament to the tradition and protocols observed in one of the most significant events in the Indian governance calendar." Sir? Yes? In this, sir, The staff themselves make the halwa. Staff themselves make it. Sir, why did it become? Sir, I wish honorable members listen, sir, because they are very scared that something is coming to hit them. When did this become a photo event? Sir, I want to underline this. Itna 2013-14 May, Mantri ji niche Sellar ne ja karke halwa batwara karne ka shuruaat 2013-14 May hua. Main puch rahi hu, tab, by that time, kyunki our leader of the opposition by that time was a full active leader. Usse pehle ordinance phata bhi gaya. वो इंडिपेंडेंस दिखाया विपक्ष के नेता क्यों उस समय फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर तब की उनसे ये पूछा नहीं गया कि कितना एससी है भाई आप नीचे जा रहे हो फोटो के लिए बोलो नहीं तो वो हलवा में कैंसिल करूंगा क्योंकि उस समय वो पावरफुल थे ना रिमोट कंट्रोल था ना वो हलवा क्यों कैंसिल नहीं किया उनके हलवा कैंसिल नहीं किया तब ये पूछा नहीं गया भारत के हलवा बटाया जा रहा सर ये आदत किसी का हो तो वो जमाना गया मलाई खा करके इस देश को छोड़कर या पार्लियामेंट को छोड़कर लोग गए लोग वोट करके मलाई खाने वाले को दिखाया रास्ता चले जाओ आप सत्ता में बैठना नहीं है वो जमाना गया मगर उस समय के फाइनेंस मिनिस्टर से ये पूछा नहीं गया आप नीचे जा रहे हो बंटवारा करने के लिए हलवा बंटवारे करने के लिए आपके साथ कितने एससी हैं कितने एसटी हैं कितने ओबीसी वो पूछा नहीं है उस समय के ऑफिसर्स लोग के स्टैटिस्टिक्स गणना नहीं हुआ मगर अभी पूछा जा रहा है इसीलिए मैं बोल रही हूँ इस देश में लोगों को बंटवारे करने में कुछ षड्यंत्र के साथ इस प्रश्न पूछा जा रहा है सर इट्स अ शेम मैं इस मौके पर मैं रिस्पेक्ट करना चाहती हूँ दो लोगों को सर आप परमिट नहीं करते हैं नए नाम लेने के लिए वो मेंबर भी नहीं है मगर प्रिंटिंग हमारा फाइनेंस मिनिस्ट्री के इम्पोर्टेंट स्टाफ दो लोग उनको मैं जिक्र करना चाहती हूँ सर ये सेक्रेट नहीं प्लीज आप सुन लीजिए सेक्रेट हलवा के विषय और इसमें इतना इमोशन जुड़ा हुआ है ये समझ में आएगा सर रिटायर्ड ऑफिसर उनके पिताजी गुजर चुके थे जब वो अंदर पहुंच गए और बाहर आने का कुछ नहीं है पॉसिबिलिटी श्री कुलदीप शर्मा जी डिप्टी मैनेजर थे प्रेस का उनके पिताजी का देहांत होने का विषय उनको अंदर होने के बाद मिला फिर भी सर वो कमिटमेंट देखिए वो जब तक फिनांस का बजट डिक्लेयर हुआ तब तक बाहर नहीं आया मैं उनके सर झुक करके नमन करता हूँ ऐसे लोग हैं सर उधर उनका सेंटिमेंट है हलवा बनाना और बंटवारा करना उनको नीचे दिखाना अच्छा नहीं है नीचे दिखाना अच्छा नहीं है दूसरा मैं बोल रही हूँ श्री सुभाष अभी भी है प्रिंटिंग प्रेस में वो भी अंदर जाने के समय उनको मैसेज आया उनके सुपुत्र का देहांत हुआ सर मगर वो बोले नहीं मेरा जिम्मेदारी क्योंकि हलवा के सेरेमनी हो गए मैं अंदर आ रही हूँ इससे आई विल नॉट कम आउट ये है सेंटिमेंट उधर हलवा बनाना और अंदर जाना पूरे कर्तव्य निभाना और बाहर आना इसको नीचे दिखाना सही नहीं है सर ओबीसी के ऊपर बहुत सारे विषय हमारे एमपी गण बात कर रहे हैं फर्स्ट प्रधानमंत्री जी नेहरू जी का लेख सबको पढ़ शायद अनुराग जी ने पढ़ दिखाया नेहरू जी ने 27 जून 1961 को लिख रहे हैं आई कोट सर आई डिसलाइक एनी काइंड ऑफ रिजर्वेशन More particularly in service. I react strongly against anything which leads to inefficiency and second-rate standards.
Same.
Unquote. Sir, that is Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of India. Okay. Next, sir. Kaka Kalekar Commission ke report 1955 mein jab recommendation aa chuka tha, tab se lekar ke Congress party ke har government usko darkinare kar diye. Backward commission ke koi kuch soch nahi tha. In 1980, Mandal Commission report was submitted to Srimati Indira Gandhi, tab ke Prime Minister. Even she didn't touch it. And tab ke Congress ke nara mein bol rahi hun, sir. My Hindi is not very good, but I'll still say it. What was the slogan? Na jaat par, na paat par, mohar lagayegi haath par. So, जात तब नहीं है, फाट नहीं है, मगर अभी बोला जा रहा है जाति, जाति. कितना लोग हलवा में थे, कितना लोग हलवा फोटो में थे, कितने नीचे पे थे, जब तब अगर आपने सही इसको तभी ले आते तो ओबीसी ऑफिसर आज सेक्रेटरी लेवल तक पहुंचे, पहुंचने का मौका था. यू स्टॉप्ड इट सर. नो. Even worse, sir. शायद अनुराग जी ने नहीं बताया, मैं एक और कोटेशन पढ़ना चाह रही हूँ सर. राजीव गांधी जी, लेट प्राइम मिनिस्टर राजीव गांधी जी, गेव एन इंटरव्यू टू आलोक मेहता इन मार्च 1985, सीनियर जर्नलिस्ट. इन दैट इंटरव्यू फॉर्मर प्राइम मिनिस्टर अबाउट ओबीसी रिजर्वेशन सेज दिस, कोट कर रही हूँ सर. No promotion of idiots in the name of reservation. And that promoting idiots in the name of reservation, and that promoting idiots in the name of reservation would harm the entire country, unquote. Reservation ke upar ye itna lecture de rahe sir. Sir, Ambedkar ji कैबिनेट से निकल करके ही सेड आई डोंट वांट टू बी इन दिस बिकॉज देयर इज नो जस्टिस फॉर बैकवर्ड कम्युनिटीज और फॉर एससीज. उनके चिट्ठी, ये सब विषय लंबा सा चिट्ठी सर, मगर वो रेलेवेंट पैराग्राफ में पढ़ रही हूँ. सो ही सेड, कोट, आई विल नाउ रेफर टू अनदर सेकेंड इन ब्रैकेट्स मैटर दैट
अंबेडकर जी का कह रहे हैं, सुनो.
I will now refer to another matter that had made me dissatisfied with the government. It relates to the treatment accorded to the backward classes and scheduled castes. I was very sorry that the constitution did not embody any safeguards for the backward classes. It was left to be done by the executive government on the basis of recommendations of a commission to be appointed by the president. More than a year has elapsed since we passed the constitution, but the government has not even thought of appointing the commission, unquote. So Ambedkar ji sarkar se chhod kar jaane.
Sarkar kiski thi?
Sarkar kiski thi sir? First government under Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first prime minister. Inke dada pardada ke bayan ye sab hai sir. Aaj ye reservation ke upar aur SC ST ke upar baat karte hain. Main प्रश्न पूछना चाहती हूँ सर. अभी
अखिलेश जी, नेताजी, लोहिया जी
इंग्लिश में बोलते हैं सर.
अरे लोहिया जी, नेताजी खिलाफ तो सर है.
इंग्लिश में बोलते हैं चैरिटी बिगिंस फ्रॉम होम. सुनिए सुनिए, चैरिटी बिगिंस फ्रॉम होम, मीनिंग आप जो दूसरे को बोल रही हो वो आप पहले कर दिखाओ. मैं पूछ रही हूँ सर, राजीव गांधी फाउंडेशन में कितने SC हैं, कितने SC हैं, कितने OBC हैं? क्योंकि बाहर के वाले लोगों का नाम पढ़ना नहीं है. 9 लोग हैं, कोई SC नहीं है. चैरिटी बिगिंस एट होम सर. आप पहले आपके व्यवस्था सही करो, SC को दो, फिर आकर हमसे पूछ लो भाई. ये बोलो सर। फिर दूसरा एक उदाहरण देती हूँ सर, राजीव गांधी चैरिटेबल ट्रस्ट, उसमें 5 लोग हैं बोर्ड ऑफ ट्रस्टीज में, नाम नहीं पढ़ रही हूँ सर, मगर मुझे एक भी एससी नहीं दिखा। सो सर, एससी एसटी लोग के ऊपर हम सब कुछ अच्छे करने के लिए इरादा रख सकते हैं, मगर जेनरेशन जेनरेशन आफ्टर परदादा दादा सब के बयान एक ही जैसे जब है और काम कुछ नहीं हुआ, आप जाकर के आज बोलेंगे तो कैसे भरोसा आएगा सर। और ऊपर से हलवा जैसे एक इमोशनल सेंटिमेंटल मैटर जिसमें पूरे उस मिंट का फाइनेंस मिनिस्ट्री के स्टाफ बंद अंदर कमरे में ये रह करके काम करते हैं, उनके मुंह मिटा करने का काम में आप ऐसे प्रश्न चिन्ह के साथ। और मैं जब इस विषय में मैं कैसे जवाब दूं ऐसे करके सर पे हाथ रखा तो पूरे ट्रोल आर्मी के साथ मुझे पूछा जा रहा है कि एससी के ऊपर जब विपक्ष के नेता बात कर रहे हैं आप सर पर हाथ रख रहे हो, हंस रहे हो। नहीं, ऐसे एक इमोशनल मैटर को इतना हल्के से डील कर रहे उसको मैं सर न फोड़ सर। थैंक यू वेरी मच सर, मैं बजट के लिए कुछ इतना समय दिए आपके लिए, मैं धन्यवाद।